where did all the races come from? But first, what is a race?
Well, according to dictionary.com, it's a contest of speed, as in driving, running, riding, or sailing.
Okay, not those kind of races. Race is a word often used to designate different people groups according to physical distinctions like skin color. But biblically, there's only one race, the human race. Right, cuz?
Right. Acts 17:26 affirms this. It says, "And he made from one man every nation of mankind to live on all the face of the earth." Mm-hmm. So from Adam came all the people everywhere, one race. We now know there's only 0.2% difference in the DNA of any two people in the world.
Wow.
And only 6% of that 0.2% is linked to so-called racial differences like skin color, confirming we're all one human family, just like the scripture says.
Science supports scripture again. Now, since we're all one race, let's redefine the question. How did differences like skin color between people arise?
Okay.
We've often shown this example of twins born in 2005. Now, you can see mom and dad have mid-brown skin. But look at the girls. How's that possible?
Well, it has to do with a pigment called melanin. Lots of melanin means darker skin, less melanin, lighter skin. And how much you produce is coded in your DNA. Melanin protects our skin from harmful ultraviolet light from the sun, so it's good to have a lot where there's lots of sunlight. That's why some of us need the SPF 500 sunscreen while others don't. Well, melanin also makes it harder to absorb vitamin D from the sun, so having less is helpful where there's less sunlight.
Skin color is governed by more than one pair of genes, but let's suppose there's only two. One form of the gene, capital M, says make lots of melanin. Another form, small m, says make a little bit. Already, possibilities range from very light to very dark, depending on what's inherited in your DNA.
I consider parents who each have four possible combinations available to pass on. This graph shows 16 possible skin tones in just one generation, which easily explains those twins. Adam and Eve likely had at least this many variations available in their DNA.
And probably Noah's family as well.
Right.
Noah's descendants all stayed in the same area around the Tower of Babel, refusing to fill the earth as God had commanded.
The confusion of languages and the dispersion of people from Babel is a key to understanding the distribution of skin shades globally. God confused their language, dispersing them into smaller groups, still with mostly middle brown skin, who migrated away from Babel, encountering new environments.
Now consider a group of people who moved to a region with little sunlight. Here, the darker skinned folk in that group would not be able to produce enough vitamin D, and so they'd be less healthy and have fewer children. So in time, the light-skinned members would be more healthy and they would come to be predominant.
Now, several different groups went to such an area, and if one group happened to be carrying few genes for lightness, this particular group could die out over time. By the way, it's natural selection acting on the characteristics already present. It doesn't create new ones.
Right. On the other hand, fair-skinned people in sunny regions could suffer from skin ulcers, skin cancer, and folate deficiency. So in these regions, dark-skinned people would be more likely to survive and they would come to be predominant.
Scientifically minded Christians have a great explanation for the distribution of skin shades around the world that's consistent with the biblical record of the ancient world.